Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Now in this video, we are going to now design the administrator login page. So let's get straight ahead. So in a previous video, we talked about how to design or how to add the master page. So we have added administrator master page. So if you go to application project, that's what we actually have now. And we did that in the previous video. All right, so for now, you know, in the previous video, we created this index. And now we've linked it to our master page now, as you know, over here. So we're going to now design our login page. So let's see, with our login page, as I have the script here, let's go in there for time sake. Let's see if we can actually have a login administrator login page. So let's see here. So that is a sign up and that is a login page here. So I'm going to copy this. And H2 for login. So I'm going to copy where you have this. Okay, so let's add the model. All right, to this end. Now let's go in there and now paste it in our project. So that's our login. So we're going to paste it here. Let's paste that. Now what this is trying to say, or what does this mean? Now what if you can check over here, we have, let's close this, you have a few view. Now this is a project, so we have added our project. We need to add our project. So in our project, it's supposed to be on top here. And now with this, we can actually pass in as at model. So our project is web form application 2.models.1. So here is TBL, now going for admin. So we need admin. So let's clear this off. And now if you check here, we have our view back the title as this, and we have our layout. So we're going to take this layout out. And now we have an H2. So here we are using the using block to generate the closing tag for us. And now HTML.begin form. So let's see. Now we have a class as row. We have the first div. So we are dividing the section, the whole row into 1, 2, 3 sections. So 4, 4, 4. So 4 times 3. Making 12. Okay, so now we have TBL admin. Now with the admin that we have to actually, let's build this first. So right click and I'll go to build solution. Let's build this solution first so you can actually have this added to our project. Now while it's being built, let's see. So we are going to, since you're generating the login, you must have the login form. And now you're using the test box here. And we're also using the password. So you need a password, test box and the password. And now we are using a lambda expression to express it, to just get it from the class, the DBL or TBL admin class we have. Okay, so we are using as lambda expression. So test box mask 2. So this x mask 2 x dot email. So now you want the email and password. So email. Let's see, so TBL admin, and we are going for admin username. So we need admin username, and here too, we're going for admin password. So x dot admin password. So going for that, and I copy this and also replace it over here. All right, so this is the validation message, and this is actually telling us that these fields are required to actually set tests in. And then we have a button and we're having a BTN success. So there is a bootstrap class that we have added. Now in order to activate this validation, let's go into the class. So that's solution explorer. Now go to admin controller. No, that is a, let's go to the model class, model folder. And now let's search for TBL, our project. So there is our project here, DB marketing. And now let's see here, we're going for TBL admin. So this is the admin. And now we're going to, let's add this using system.component.data_annotations. And now henceforth, you can actually pass in required for to this. So let's pass in required. So this means that the user can't type in anything else unless the person fills the data. So you pass in error message. And now with this error message, let's pass in username. So admin username is required. So let's say username. No, you're using email. Yeah, username is required. Username field is required. Okay, and now let's copy the same thing and now let's pass it onto the attribute of this. So the password, so we are going to say that password field also required. Now let's save this. So this is going to have in connection with what you have in the login, so this side, and you're going to display that here. Okay, so this is what you have now. And now the next thing to do here is we have to perform the controller operation here. And now in order to perform that, let's see a quick way to actually do it. Now let's try to public login. Now here, let's have the login term from this side. So let's copy this. And now in our page here, our login, this is what we're going to do. Let's pass in this. Now what does this mean? So we are creating an instance of our TBL login, but before that you must create our context. So our object context, we're going to pass in over here. So you know the context that we set was DB marketing context. So we copy that, and on top of this we paste this here. So DB marketing context, we create the object of it. Then we're going to use the object TBL admin is equal to tbl.admin, then where admin username. Okay, so it's equal to, but before that we must pass in the TBL admin here, and now we pass in a VM. So this is going to hold this, and I'll check. So you see that you're having a TBL, this was a TBL admin. But before that, you must check, this is going to return when the person first log in. This is going to return. So this is what you're going to do. Now from this angle, let's copy this. We're going to copy this, and we're going to paste this as login. So let's separate this. Now all of this, we're going to clear that off, and we're going to take also this off as well. Now what is this going to, this is going to respond to a get request. So we can decide to indicate a get request as HTTP get request here, and let's indicate this at post request. So HTTP post, HTTP post request. Okay, and now we have the TBL admin. So we have TBL admin, create an object of it, and we say admin is equal to dbl.tbladmin.whereX. So let's see where x dot admin username, so ad username is equal to this. So let's see this dot username. So and where password, so and where x dot password, where x dot ad password is equal to avm dot ad password dot single or default. So now we are making a search, and we are having ad, so tbl admin. Now you can just actually copy this. So if admin here, if admin, it is not null, so it means when the data is found, then we want to store the session as admin id. So the session here, we are making it as ad id, so that admin id is equal to, so admin dot, so let's clear this, so admin dot, so add username. Okay, so that's the username or user ad id, so dot to string. You convert it to to string, then we redirect this user to, let's say there's a view category. So view categories, we are now going to create a view category. So there's going to be a view that we are going to create. That is when everything goes on successfully. Now the next thing is, in case admin here, it is null, you couldn't find a record in database, how are you going to do it? Then we are stating a view back error as invalid username or password, then return to the view. So this is what the login is going to actually handle with. Okay, so that's the login. Now we have to create this view, but for now let's see. So let's run this application and see what's going to happen next. So let control plus F5. Now let's run this and see. So we are going to log in. Now if you check our database, let's see. So let's create a new query here. Let's see if that you have. All right, now let's select star from TBL admin. Now let's find this and see the sample data that we have. We can actually pass in. Let's connect. All right, so admin, we have no data here. Let's select this. A data table at DB Marketing. Let's run this. Next, we have root admin 123, and test admin 123. So we're going to use any of this to log into our page. So let's wait for this to open. Then we use that to log in into the page. All right, so now let's navigate to the admin. So admin.index. It must have the login page open like this. So you see we have the login page here. And now we are going to pass in the email. Okay. So the email here, we are having just a root here. And then the password is admin123. Now, when you log in successfully, you must get back to the view category. So you see, since we haven't created a view category, we are having a 404, meaning page not found. Let's try to log in with a different or wrong password. So admin1234. And let's see what's going to happen here. So you can see we have invalid username or password. Now let's clear everything here. Let's click on login. You can see we have fixed these errors. Username field is required, password field is required, and invalid name or password. Okay, so that is it for the login. So you can see that we're able to log into our project. As long as we pass in the correct credentials, we are good to go. So 1, 2, 3. Now you can see we've now logged into a view category. All right, so that is it for this video. So today we see that we've talked about how to actually create the login system. And at the next time, we talk about how to design the sign up for admin. How to design the sign up for admin. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this is clear. I'm going to see you in the next video.